What's up, everybody? We are live for your UFC Strayamate picks. We got UFC Robert Whittaker, mate, versus Kevin Gastelum. So, first off, I'm going to breeze right through these picks. I've got Tiroshi Ishihara for your first pick. Then I've got, I don't know what the fuck I wrote down. So we'll move on to the next one. Yes, Kaikara France. That's my next pick. Shoo! Then I've got Dong Hong Mai, a.k.a. Mai Hong Dong. I mean, why would you not bet on a guy and his name backwards is Mai Hong Dong? Come on. Smiling Sam Alvey. Everybody hates this guy. And I just love Sam Alvey so much. I guess he's so goofy. He has to win. I'm telling you, Sam Alvey. Put your fucking money on it. Sam Alvey's wife has his balls. This is a very true statement. Sam Alvey's wife looks like from the hot bitch from The Fifth Element, the Mila Jovovich bitch. Jovovich bitch. The winner will be Sam Alvey's wife. Oh, what's that Anderson gonna win? I feel like Stylebender is going to put Anderson in the camel clutch, break his back, and make him humble. Oh, ooh, next, yeah, whoa, hey, man, 15-0, I don't know, Bond, that's a lot of not losing going on, and this is a TRT minus TRT Silva, so I don't know. I would love to see Anderson win, but we know how TRT, post-TRT people do. They are very shit. Okay, you are right on that part, Bond. You are right. They do hype beasts like no other in the UFC, but I just feel like Stylebender not going to lose at home. This facts. It'll be a good fight either way. We will not be disappointed. That's that I know for sure. Unless it's like some fucking UFC 134 Abu Dhabi bullshit. Anderson, Silva, Damian Mild, turtle fuck. That. God. I will almost never forgive you for that, Anderson. How dare you? You just did the fucking moonwalk around Damian Maya for 20 minutes. It was boring as fuck. Don't ever do that again, fam. Do not ever do that again. Montana De La Rosa. Hola, mami. Mucho gusto. I mean, hey. Woof. Montana is pretty steamy. I'd have to say between her and the other bitch, I've got to vote for Montana. I'm putting my money on who's likely, who am I likely to scissor? Montana, you get all my money. Damn it. Next, Ronnie Yahya for the win. I only bet on Ronnie Yahya because he reminds me of my homie Jimmy Yahya from back in the day. Shout out to Jimmy Yahya. And then my next pick, the last Stylebender. He's just not going to lose it at home. I'm sorry, fam. He's not going to lose at home, fam. Israel is not going to lose at home. I hate to say it. If this fight was in Brazil, then Anderson would win. But TRT, no mas, long layoff. Sorry, Anderson. The last Stylebender wins. And finally, Robert motherfucking Whittaker. Okay? Don't make me choose! Robert motherfucking Whittaker by Bloodbath. They're going to go toe-to-toe and bleed all over each other like it is that time of the week. Ah, thanks so much for tuning in, guys. I appreciate y'all. All right, those are your UFC picks. Pick along if you'd like or not. Fast forward if you must. If you're already listening to this, it's too late. The picks are over, so you can't fast forward because the show's starting. Let's go.
Hit that ball.
Lambica Radio with your host, Gen T.
Yeah, fucking Gen is a warlord.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to Rambo Bro Radio. I am your host, Gen T. Twitter and Instagram at GenT523. What's good, motherfuckers? I'm so glad to talk to you guys, and I got lots of shit to say. So let's get started. So, Saturday was me friend Dave's birthday. Shout out to the Dave of the Spruno. It was his birthday. The lovely Dave, the late great Dave. The wonderful Dave. It was his birthday. And we celebrated. We were very festive celebrating Dave's birthday at a sushi place. I will not mention the name. When we walked in, smelled like fish. And I thought the rule was, if you smell fish, you don't eat there. But nobody died, so everything's all right. But I got scurred, fam. So I ate the lovely, delicious house salad. Shout out to that sushi place in Redlands. You can ask me the name later if you'd like. I just ate the house salad because I was too scurred to eat any sort of animal when I smelt the fishies of the fish when we walked in. So I got a little scared. But the best part is coming up, of course. Something that's been pressing on my mind this week. Kindness. That's right, being kind. I struggle with this greatly. I think it has something to do with patience as well, because a lot of these whack-a-mo customers wear me out. So when finally some legitimate customer who needs help comes in, my give-a-damn's busted. Kindness. This week, I experienced the usual not-so-kind things, but I still try to be kind as best that I can. For example, I had an experience at work with not one, but two coworkers. Just being rude. Just being bossy. And my thought is, you know, I've been nothing but kind. I don't deserve to be on the missile end of your rampage of rudeness or bossiness. You know, being nice goes a long way, especially with me. I respect that. What I don't respect is just being rude as hell and be bossy. Look, when you display those characteristics to me, when I see them, when I experience them, or when I witness them within other people, that just shows me you're not in control of the situation. If you want to be in control of a situation, it's called respect. You don't need to be bossy. You don't need to be rude to get people to do things for you. It's real easy. If you respect the person you're working with, they will respect you, simple as that. When you are rude or you're bossy, well, then that doesn't harbor respect. That harbors resentment. And a shining example was, I approached my coworker with something and no eye contact was made at all. No eye contact was made through a 2-minute conversation. So I said, okay, cool. So you're trying to be disrespectful, or you just don't even flat out care what's going on. But I actually have a customer here who needs your help. So if you could stop being rude for 5 seconds, and help this person, that would be really rad. Oh, so unfortunately, that normally I'm pretty good, but I hit a breaking point when I was warming up on the bag the next day. I thought about that person and I thought about their face and I thought about how hard could I punch this punching bag thinking of their face, thinking of their name. And then I realized it wasn't just them. It was also a further incident that I had experienced, which happened on Saturday at the Escape Brewery in Redlands. So there are two types of people that go to the brewery. There are nice, and this is just for any brewery. It doesn't matter whether it's Escape, Area 51, JPP Brewery, Flim Flam Brewery, your mom's brewery. It don't matter. Two types of people go to the brewery. Nice people who like beer and fucking idiots who like beer. And unfortunately, I ran into a fucking idiot who likes beer. This fucking idiot proceeded to talk to me about something non-legible, because he was so drunk out of his mind, I couldn't comprehend what he was saying. So I was just like, great, that's awesome. Well, he didn't like that I wasn't engaging in the conversation with him, and he proceeded to do the tap tap on the chest. Hey, where I come from, tap tap is fighting. You want to fight. So what the fuck, man? And this was not some little ass dude. This dude was probably maybe 6'2", 6'4", and had a biscuit chin like nobody's business. I could just tell by the shape of his fucking pointy nose that he needed to be punched. But I didn't. I didn't do it, fam. I felt like a failure. I should have decked this guy in the next week. I should have kicked him right in the fucking jables. But I didn't, because I knew in the split second of him doing the tap tap on my chest, I said, how is this going to look when these guys call when these guys at Escape Brewery call the cops, because there's no security in that place, because it's mostly just white people having a good time. And here comes the angry black. Arrest the angry black. I just knew. I ran through that whole scenario in my head within seconds, and I was like, do not punch this asshole. Do not punch this fucking asshole jerk off face. Do not do it. Because you will be in so much trouble. Nothing's going to happen to this dude, but you're going to be in trouble. So do not punch this guy in the face. You know how to fight. It's not fair. He's drunk out of his ass. It's not a good idea. Just walk away. And so I did. And it only got worse, friends. It only got worse. Some whack-a-mole who looked like the bad guy from Big Trouble in Little China just walked up to my friend and took a picture with her. I was like, hey, what? Like, what? And I was like, do you know that guy? And she's like, no. I was like, what the fuck is this place, man? It's fucking weirdos. And then, some other weirdo just grabs my friend's wife, just like puts his arm around her like he knows her or something. And we all thought he knew her. She's like, no, I don't know this guy. And I was like, oh, well, that's fucking weird. We should probably leave. I can't stand it, man. I cannot stand weirdos. Listen, if you want to drink, cool. Eat, drink, and be merry. But please, be able to control your liquor. Don't be a fucking ass clown. Don't do it, man. If you can't control your liquor, if you're going to be grabby on chicks, taking pictures with them, being all weird and shit and inappropriate, you probably shouldn't be allowed to have more than 2 or 3 drinks. And then you got to go. You got to get the fuck out. And what the fuck's wrong with Escape Brewery for not having security in that place? Proving once again that this shit never happens at wine tastings. Never. I have been to countless wine tastings and this has never happened. Everybody is so well-mannered and civilized. I'm telling you, if they are drunk, they are laughing and having a good time. I have never been grabbed at a wine tasting. I've never had my friends get grabbed at a wine tasting. So that just shows you what goes on at a brewery. These fucking frat-a-tat losers just grabbing chicks. I mean, what's wrong with you, man? Oh, my girlfriend. Blah, 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 blah. Okay, dude. Okay. I don't want to talk to you. Take a hike. You don't want to take no for an answer, so you want to grab me? Oh, get the fuck out of here, man. Piece of garbage, man. It's terrible. So after that, I was pissed. And then that, literally 2 days later, had that situation at work, and I was just like, fuck! And I had to let loose on the punching bag. It actually helped my workout because I was so pissed. So pissed. I took it all out on the bag, and I felt better. So by the time I got to work to deal with these jackals, I was so tired. Oh, man. It's so important to exercise caution. You know, in that split second, everything could have changed. I could have blasted that dude in the face and gone to jail. I could have yoked my coworkers outside and gotten fired and gone to jail. But it's important to exercise kindness. And remember, those people who do not respect you or show you respect or common fucking decency don't deserve to be in your life. If they are and you have to work with them, cool. Just know that I won't do you any fucking favors. If I saw your ass on the street and you was on fire, I wouldn't piss on you to put it out. That's the truth. I'm being honest. Respect goes a long ways. That's what I was raised on. And if you're going to be disrespectful, then you don't get my respect. Plain and simple. That's it. Don't care if you're a lady or you're a man. We all need to respect each other and be kind. Be kind, rewind. Come on. Look at me here. I have the ability to punch people in the face and I don't do it. You know why? Because I know I'm respectful. I say, you know what? That person doesn't deserve to be in my life. Or you know what? Outside of work or outside of this business relationship, if we're talking about bets or if you're buying something from me on eBay or whatever, cool. We do business, but that's about it. I would never go to lunch with you. I would never do dinner with you. I would never go to a wine tasting with you. I would never go to a basketball game with you. I would never go to a hockey game with you. I would never go to a concert with you. That's it. We can work together and be civil, and we don't have to get along. But I certainly believe that we can be respectful of one another. And if you're not going to show the gratitude of respect to me or to the people that I respect, then I don't respect you. It's over. It's a wrap. I'm talking influential albums at Block Talkie. This week's influential album is Queen. I pray for you. Man, Queen is my shit. I love Queen so much. When I was, maybe 11 or 12 years old, Queen had released, it was like a 20 year anniversary of Queen or something like that. I don't remember the specific details, but they had released this box, this box called the Crown Jewels, and it was a velvet box full of every single record Queen had ever made, and that shit cost $350. And I said, man, I don't have $350. You know how many weeks of chores I have to do? So I said, Mom, Dad, please, for the love of God, this is all I want. And they said, okay, well, if we buy this for you, no birthday, no Christmas. And I said, deal. And so I got that for Christmas. And it was the best Christmas ever. I had every single Queen album ever made in the Crown Jewels velvet box. I used to just pet the box. Yeah, I know what you're thinking. I pet boxes. Yeah, and some lady boxes too. No. The Crown Jewels, that was my shit. And I had everything they had ever made into one thing. And I would listen to it over and over and over and over and over again. But this is influential albums. I can't play all of Queen's albums on here. But what I can do is play the first one that I got, which inspired me to ask for the Crown Jewels. And that was Queen's Greatest Hits. It was the green covered CD cover. It was green or blue? Yes, I am victorious. So my obsession with Queen was an all-time high. And I believe it was last year that they released a movie called Bohemian Rhapsody, which was the story of Freddie Mercury, except it had no gay stuff in it. So, people were asking me, they said, oh, have you seen that Queen movie? It's awesome. You're a Queen fan. How have you not seen this movie? And I said, hello. Behind the Music, VH1 did a excellent piece, and they actually have Freddie in it. So why would I want to watch a movie with somebody else playing Freddy? That's not Freddy. Freddy's dead. And it's very hard for me to suspend disbelief because Freddie Mercury was a goddamn superhero, man. He had the AIDS. He didn't care. He's singing his little heart out until he died. Oh, man. And he was gay as hell. Well, I think at the time it was kind of seeky-seeky, but for the most of us, for us gays, we knew Freddie was on our team, of course. That Bohemian Rhapsody movie, I was told, was no new information. It was just if you weren't really much of a Queen fan that you would get into Queen after this. And of course, everyone is obsessed with Queen now. But I have been obsessed with Queen since the beginning. It's okay. You can join on too. Freddie and Queen and Roger. Everybody is fucking amazing. So, taking you in to classic Queen. And it's a kind of magic. Kind of magic. Burning. Oh, God. I mean, hearing Freddie just belt out these notes, this kind of magic. Freddie had that magic that most frontmen wish they dream of having and they would never have. Freddie was fucking badass. He was just doing the most, being gay as hell, singing his little heart out. Oh my God, how do you not love Freddie? Next up is Bohemian Rhapsody, and you'd have to be living under a motherfucking rock if you don't know this song. Fantasy caught in a slot. No escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and say, hey, I'm just a doctor. David O'Dimbody. Flim, flam, glow. Squeeze, squeeze, squat. Skitty, low. And it's red, I see. Man, this song took over 70 hours to record and 180 dub overs just so they could double up over their voices and make all of these lovely sounds that you hear. Man, these all of these voices like this. How do you not love that shit, man? That is the greatest song ever! Bohemian motherfucking Rhapsody. Damn it.
And there are reports that he wrote that song as him talking about his alternative life if he would have just come out of the closet and told everybody who his boyfriend was, but he didn't. So he wrote that song, and my goodness, it's kind of good that he stayed in the closet so he could write this epic song. 70 hours of recording, guys. Come on. You got to give it up for the queen. Next was, whew, man, this song right here. Man, so many people jock that bass line. Vanilla Ice, Ice Ice Baby. But you cannot top the... this epic piece. Pressure. Man, I love this song so much because I'm a hardcore David Bowie fan, and I jizzed in my pants when they did this duet together. I was like, oh my god, my two superheroes in music, they are in one song together. Yes, this is awesome. I'm knowing what this world is about. I'm watching some good friends scream, let me out. I never know what they say here. Son of a bum, but I don't buy. Mr. Bell, did you know I'm missing time in the. Oh god, I'm telling you, just hours and hours of a child just singing these songs so fucking loud. And I thought I was singing with Freddie and David. I'm a big man, but I'm down. Man in the name of bam bam down. Man. And then this rockin' crew. Hammer the fall. Some of these deep tracks that were still hits, but if you weren't balls deep in Queen, you didn't know the hammer to fall. It was like, it was some epic shit. And then, of course, Stone Cold Crazy. Everybody covered this motherfucker. Metallica covered this shit. Everybody loved this shit. Stone Cold Crazy. God, how are you sitting down right now? Are you not rocking out to this shit? Come on, motherfuckers! We had 1 year of love, and Slow Queen for me, initially, like I said, you know, I was a little white child growing up, even though I'm black as hell. I was a little white child growing up, so I wanted to rock all the time. I wanna rock, rock! So Slow Queen, I was like, what the fuck is this, man? Where's the guitars? Where's the, what? But I appreciate it now, and I was a big fan of the Highlander series, the TV show, and the movies, of course, and there's a part where he's fallen in love, of course, because he's this dude who never dies, and the poor guy always falls in love with these people, and they die. His women die because they don't have the ability to live forever like the Highlanders do, so... this 1 year of love track is like, it's some raw shit on there. I challenge y'all to listen to this. You know, if you're just needing some quiet time, you just need a moment of peace, put on 1 year of love. Ooh. This song right here, I want you to understand, this song right here was the reason a certain artist by the name of Lady Gaga has her name, Stephanie Flim Flam, her stage name, as you know, is Lady Gaga, and she got it from this Queen song. And Radio Gaga is like, it's slow, but you're feeling it. You're just like, Mommy, here is Radio Gaga, Radio Moo Moo, Radio Gaga, Mommy, here is Radio Gaga. This song is dope, fam. I'm telling you, this was like the first Queen slow song that I could get into, because when I was a kid, I was like, man, Radio Baba, like, I do miss my Baba sometimes, but I'm a big kid now. I can't use Baba anymore. Damn it, Queen. Oh. Ooh, this song used to creep me out. I couldn't listen to the song late at night because it was, I'm going slightly mad. And then I felt like somebody was going to get murdered in the background. Yo, I was like, oh God, I can't listen to this song. I could only listen to this song during the daylight hours because it would freak me the fuck out. I'm like, oh, yo, this is fucking crazy, man. And then, I want it all. I want it all. I want it all. And I want it now. Man, I want it all. So powerful. It's just like, woo. Whatever you want, you go get it and you want it now. Fuck. How crazy is that shit? You want it all and you want it now. Even though it's not good to want everything, but it's good to want some things. But Freddie was like, nah, motherfucker, fuck that. I want everything. I want it all and I want it now. Man, what a great song. So powerful. I mean, you put that on, you're going to be at the gym. One, two, three, four. You're going to be doing some serious squats, some serious deadlifts with I want it out. I want it out. I want it out. I want it now. I'm sure you're sitting in your car right now, stuck in traffic. You're like, I want to get out of this traffic. And I want right now. Oh. Tie your mother down. Tie your mother down. Ooh. This was a song I was a little uncomfortable with because I was like, what the fuck? Why am I tying my mom down? And then he said, give me all your loving tonight. Whoa, wait a minute. Hey, are you trying to bone your mom, Freddie? I don't subscribe to mom boning. I mean, I may or may not watch mom porn on the internet, but I don't want to bone my mom. That's fucking weird, fam. So I would seldomly listen to that song. As I got older, I was into it because I was just rocking out. But when I was younger, I was like, man, ooh, I ain't trying to bone my mom. This is weird, fam. I gotta skip. The next track, Miracle, was the first Queen song that I just sat and thought. Of course, it's slow. So automatically at first, I was like, no slow songs. But when I sat and thought about it, when I just needed to calm down for a moment, I sat and listened to the lyrics. And all of these things, these miracles that Freddie was singing about, it's a miracle that all of these things that happen, the world turns, we live and breathe, you know, babies are being born, people are loving, people are fighting, and, you know, relationships are being shared and flourishing and growing. And the biggest message from the miracle song is that the one thing we're all waiting for is peace on earth and into war. Holy shit, Freddie! It's a miracle! It's a miracle! It's a miracle! Okay, the next song, was so damn slow, I couldn't get into it, but every now and then I would listen to it. These long days of our lives. And I would really only listen to it because I watched the Days of Our Lives soap. Wasn't one of my favorite Freddies, but I appreciate it now as I am older, of course. Because these are the days of our lives. We're fully in control of what's going on. You decide if you want to stand still, keep moving, push forward, be sad, be happy. It's all decisions. It's all choices that we make each day, and that propels us into the directions that we're going. And it is very true. These are the days of our lives. One vision, one flash, I'm black. I'm gonna tell you there's no black and no white. One race, one goal, one true religion. One fight, one goal, my real decision. Man, we only one vision. People, listen to that. Freddie is telling us we gotta get together and be as one. There's only one vision here. We are all people with different individual thoughts, but if we work together to create one vision, that we can all live in harmony. People are going to agree to disagree, but if we all can work together and be a part of one vision, it works. It makes it an easier time on earth. And this is just like your pump up anthem. You're just like, yeah, I'm gonna get my teamwork together. I'm gonna work with people. I wanna do awesome things. And you got that one vision, man. And then of course, this is my anthem. As some of you may or may not know, I had some issues with I've had some life-altering things. I had a lady dive on top of my head, almost snap my neck. I should have been dead, but I got lucky. I've been in several car accidents. I've fallen asleep at the wheel numerous amounts of times. I've had tumors removed from my body several times. And this song, keep yourself alive, keep yourself alive, make your diamond to table, hold up, keep your smile. That's all I try to do is keep myself alive. And this one, like most of the Queen songs, I would always love to play this one on the drums because there's a dope drum solo in the middle. It's like, yeah, that just would motivate me. I was like, I gotta stay alive. Mother Nature's trying to kill me. I gotta fight back and stay alive. And even sometimes when I'm in my fights, I'll hear this jam. Keep myself alive. Don't get knocked out. Next is Headlong. Got your mics and Headlong. Next to Headlong. Another groove that will just keep you moving. I mean, this all of Queen's music, it just gets your foot stomping. And you're just moving. You move for the beat. You're excited. You're pumped. You're ready to kick ass. You're ready to kick ass and take names. And then when they're slow songs, it's like, you feel it. You feel the emotion, the raw emotion of Freddie singing. Like, he wants to live forever. Prepare to live forever. The song from Highlander, Who Wants to Live Forever? I mean, think about it. It sounds cool at first, I thought about it. But then when I think about it, when I watch the TV show The Highlander or the movie The Highlander, it's miserable living forever. Because most people, you know, unless they have that special Highlander power, is they're gonna die. And you feel sad, and so you begin to not want to be attached to people because you know they're gonna die before you will because you live forever. Then the other side of that, I think, is we are definitely not going to live forever. I'm sure with the modern advancement of medicine, as it gets crazier and crazier, that people will start to live longer. But I feel like if you are a good person, meaning your intentions are to do good things and do things for people or others, or you're trying to help out, I believe that that spirit lives on forever, that you want to do good things. You want to make people laugh. You want to participate. You want to show people new, exciting ideas. I think that is what lives on forever. That inspires the generation and the generation behind that generation to do good things. And look at Steve Jobs. I'm talking to you on an Apple device right now. His ideas and thoughts and visions. Steve Jobs is no longer with us. He passed away from that darn pancreatic cancer. But his thoughts and ideas, or at least things similar to those, live on forever. Look at this technology and the way that it shaped so many people's lives. Steve did that. Look at the person who invented the cell phone. They're almost dead, but they certainly... their technology lives on forever. Obviously, it's been improved to what it used to be. The dude who invented the cell phone saw an episode of Star Trek, and that's how he invented the cell phone. Star Trek from the fucking 60s, man. What you do today, how your attitude is, how you are as a human being, if you display goodness amongst yourself in your shine, you are an example for other people. I feel like that idea, that mindset, that positive mindset, that go-getting mindset to get things done and be kind to those who you meet, that lives on forever. Just like this Queen song. Lives on forever. Oh, and finally, as Freddie always knew, because he knew he was dying of AIDS, but he knew that the show must go on, and that's what he did. Even in his last days of dying, he was still out there singing and taking pictures and doing press stuff and just trying to be the best Freddie he could, even though he was very, very, very sick from HIV. And when I think about how the advancement in medicine has changed, Magic Johnson got it, and it's undetectable. My God, Freddie. If he just would have gotten it 15 years later, he'd probably still be alive. It's crazy. It's just absolutely crazy. In those times in the late 70s, early 80s, even in the 90s, you got AIDS and it was a death sentence. You were gonna, that was it. That was a rope. And that was the end. And Freddie knew that the show must go on. Man, the show must go on, and that's what Freddie did. And it's just one of those things that inspires me to do this show, because I know there are times where I don't feel good. I've had a migraine headache so bad for 3 days. It's caused nausea. I've barely wanted to eat food. I've still been training because the show must go on. I've got goals I've got a goal weight to get to. I've got a podcast to do for y'all. I've got a podcast to do for me, too. I got to get this shit out of my mind. And the show must go on. It doesn't matter how I'm feeling. When it comes to the end of the week, it's time for me to get on the ones and the twos and spit this game here and let y'all know what's going on with my life, whether it's popular or not. That's just what I feel. And I feel like the show will go on, and regardless of whether or not it's a good show or not, I do it each week because I love it. And when I receive compliments from people, or if they critique, you know, I appreciate every bit of it, because that tells me to keep motherfucking going. The show will go on. The show will go on until I get sued for using all this copywritten material. Oh, man, I encourage all of you who are not familiar with Queen to please, for the love of God, go check them out on Spotify, Apple Music, YouTube. Watch that VH1 Behind the Music even. You know, it's really cool stuff. And let's not take away from the rest of the band. They have an outstanding band. The drummer is
superb. He's just got this larger than life. He's got like three drum sets smashed together with a giant gong behind him. Guy's a monster. And then, of course, Brian May on guitar. Great talent. And rest in peace, Freddie. You will be missed. Your spirit lives on forever through your music. Your music lives on forever, man. That's why it's so awesome. You're not here, Freddie, but your music is. And that is truly fantastic. That ends this week's Influential Albums. I hope you enjoyed it. Go download some good music, fam. And now it's time for Customers of the Week. This week, Weed Granny stopped by. How's it going? I was like, oh no, oh no, Weed Granny. How you doing, Weed Granny?
Hey, baby, how's it going?
I'm doing good. Gotta go.
Oh, baby, I'm just here getting some of this juice. I need some of this juice.
Oh, okay. Well, the juice is right here, Weed Granny. Okay, I've got to go help some customers.
What the hell is this juice? That ain't the juice that I bought, baby.
Where's Uncle Matt? Where's Uncle Matt? And I was like, huh? Who's Uncle Matt? I don't know who the fuck that is. You're not related to me. Where's Uncle Matt? I can't see him. And I was like, oh no, Weed Granny is on some shit right now. She is stoned out of her mind looking for an Uncle Matt. So I thought I was going to have to get on the intercom and page for an Uncle Matt.
She's like, baby, I can't find Uncle Matt. Where is he? I can't see him.
I was like, well, of course, you're stoned out of your mind. Could you see at all? Did you drive here? I hope not.
Where's Uncle Matt, baby? Oh, I need help. I can't see him. I don't want to buy any other juice.
And I was like, huh?
She's like, yeah, Uncle Matt's juice. I mean, who is this Lakewood? I don't know who he is. I only know Uncle Matt.
I'm like, oh my God. Uncle Matt is a juice company? Ugh, Christ. Weed Granny, why didn't you just say juice in the first place? God. I was like, here is your juice right over here, Granny.
Oh, baby, I don't see Uncle Matt. Do you know if Lakewood is good? Who is he? Is he an uncle or something?
I was like, I don't know, Weed Granny. I really don't know. I really don't know who Uncle Lakewood is. I really don't know who Uncle Matt is either. I could give two fucks. Jog off, Weed Granny. He's got things to do. And then as I was getting ready to turn about face from Weed Granny goes,
oh my God, baby. Look at that lady over there. I mean, when I was her age, I would never wear an outfit like that.
And I turned around.
Hola, Mami. Mucho gusto.
Whoa. A hattie with the body was in the dairy section getting her milk. She needs some milk. This lady with the shortest skirt I've ever seen in my life was getting some milk. And I was like, man, hey. Damn it. I mean, what possesses you ladies to be wearing these short skirts to the grocery store? I mean, hey, that wasn't a work skirt. That was a I'm on the prowl skirt. I'm looking for some D skirt. What in God's green earth? I mean, what are you thinking? We're all going to look. I'm a gay lady. I'm going to look. You can't wear a skirt that short, and I'm not going to look. And then Weed Granny was like, oh, God, baby, that girl going to be labeled to get raped or something. This is a prostitute wear. And I was like, shh, shut up, Weed Granny. Don't be a hater. Don't be a hater just because you old now and you can't fit into your old granny hole clothes. Doesn't give you the right to be a hater. But damn, this Ola Mami, and I was like, hello, how can I help you? You need some milk?
She's like, no, I'm fine, thank you. Where's your beef jerky? And I was like, it's on aisle one. Let me jerk it to you. God. I'm sorry, ma'am. I mean, the beef jerky's on aisle one. Ride this jerk. Jerk this way. Oh, man. Jeez. A lady that hot should not be wearing clothes like that. I'm just telling you. And I'm just like, man, what is that? I just figure, like, your husband at work, he's working some crazy ass business job, so you can pull up in your Range Rover with your Louis Vuitton bag and your short skirt that you be wearing, and you just go to the grocery store on a Tuesday wearing that. Huh? You're just trying to piss your man's off, huh? Because he's out busting his balls, working hard to buy you shit. And then you're like, he's not home to love me. He's not home to love me. I better get people to look at me when I wear this short skirt. I know exactly what's going on, and I fucking fell for it. Oh, God damn it. Holy shit. Holy shit. So, yeah, this old mommy was like, man, you... Hey, you might want to have a security guard with you. Just saying. Some guy is not going to be able to resist temptation. I just have a feeling. Oh, damn. But guys, if a lady looks that damn good, you stay away, okay? Unless she's single and you got her permission, you do not engage. Don't be like that dickhead in a Barbie grabbing ladies, okay? You show some respect, okay? I gotta tell you guys about something. Since I was just in that mood, since I was just in the funk between that guy grabbing me at the bar and then my coworkers being rude and bossy. And I don't want to say all coworkers, it was just a polite few. The real ones are cool. They're respectful. They know what's up. They don't want to talk. They just say, I don't feel like talking. We cool. But these other ones, though, man, they need an attitude adjustment. And I feel like I should give it to them, but I'm going to be respectful and politely let Mother Nature attitude adjust those motherfuckers. So this week, there was a podcast, and I'm sure if you've heard it before, the Joe Rogan Show, and he talked about this. And I just want to play that for anybody who needs this shit right now, who needs a motherfucking boost. A boost like no other. And particularly when things are going bad, no matter how shitty life is, you just say good.
Pull me aside with Jocko. Some major problem, some issue that was going on. And he'd say, boss, we got this and that and the other thing. And I'd look at him and I'd say, good. And finally, one day he was telling me about some issue that he was having, some problem. And he said, I already know what you're going to say. And I said, well, what am I going to say? He said, you're going to say good. He said, that's what you always say. When something is wrong and going bad, you always just look at me and say, good. And I said, well, yeah, when things are going bad, there's going to be some good that's going to come from it. Didn't get the new high-speed gear we wanted? Good. Didn't get promoted? Good. More time to get better. Oh, mission got canceled? Good. We can focus on another one. Didn't get funded? Didn't get the job you wanted? Got injured? Sprained my ankle. Got tapped out? Good. Got beat? Good. We learned. Unexpected problems? Good. We have the opportunity to figure out a solution. That's it. When things are going bad, don't get all bummed out. Don't get startled. Don't get frustrated. If you can say the word good, guess what? It means you're still alive. It means you're still breathing. And if you're still breathing, well, then hell, you still got some fight left in you. So get up, dust off, reload, recalibrate, re-engage, and go out on the attack. Come on. Don't you want to just go run through a fucking wall right now?
Come on, motherfuckers! Are you good? Hey, I said, are you good? Get up on your feet. Get out of your car. Stop doing laundry. Stop eating. Stop punching somebody in the face. Stop running on that treadmill. Drop those weights. Are you good? Check in with yourself right now. Check in. Are you good? Are you alive? You still got breath in you? Good. Now get after it. God damn it, I'm telling you. If you need that boost, there it is, people. You gotta get it done. Good. Somebody's being an asshole? Good. Somebody's being rude and bossy? Good. Somebody's trying to fight you? Good. Hey, I'm on fire, motherfuckers. I'm just telling you. This is something that is so important. You can always go back to being good. Square one. Good. Something doesn't work out. Good. Time to work on something else. Shit's going down. Good. That means you can figure a way out of it. Can't figure a way out of it? Good. Think of something else to do. Jocko Podcast. I'm telling you, fam, Jocko's the motherfucking man. He is a former Navy SEAL. He knows. He's been in Iraq. He's been in Afghanistan. He knows. And that mindset where you just get it done at all costs, that there is no excuses. You get it motherfucking done. Whether it's your workout, your homework, your work, your dream, you get it motherfucking done. Accept no substitutes. Something that has always plagued my entire life. These straight girls that I seem to fall in love with. I'm not going to name names, of course. I have to protect the innocent. But these straight girls who play games. God, I cannot do it. See, this is the thing. Straight girls love to flirt with lesbians. You know why? Because it's like, ooh, I can attract men and women. Ooh, I'm hot. Both people want to bone me. Okay, great. But here I am, a regular ass lesbian who just trying to get a date, who just trying to bone. So are we boning or not? And I heard this clip on the Anxiety Radio, which is, of course, the gay radio show, but everybody can listen to it, of course. But they mentioned how lesbians, we are right to the motherfucking point. We don't play games. It's not like, ooh, straight girl, you want to do me? No, it's like, look, do you want a bone or not? Do you want to move in or not? Do you want to U-Haul it? Do you want to be my wife? I mean, we're right to the motherfucking point. We don't play games. Now, when we play games with other lesbians, as far as, ooh, I like her, I like you. Okay, yeah. But specifically, when it comes to dating, we are right to the motherfucking point. So, a lot of my adolescence was a lot of straight girls who wanted to flirt, who wanted some of the Rambo Oprah. And most of them didn't get it because I just knew. Y'all are playing games. That's what y'all are designed to do. It's in your DNA. You ladies, particularly the straights, shots fired. Y'all like to play games. Y'all like to be chased. Y'all want to do this. Nah, I ain't. I don't have time for it. It's like, look, are we boning or not? Do you want this or not? And so it was bluntly put very clear on Anxiety Radio, and I will play this clip for you. And yes, I said clit. It was an accident, fam. God damn it. Gay, not that gay. Sheesh. Okay, maybe. Okay, here it is from Anxiety Radio with Zara and Donnie. And yeah, this pretty much read my mind for the last 20 years. Look straight, girls. We ain't playing games like you do. Us gay ladies, we're right to the point. So if you want to bone, we're boning. Otherwise, we're not. So stop trying to pretend like you want to bone us.
and either just say, yeah, I want a bone, or keep it moving, okay?
I think you need to ask. I think you need to do what lesbians are really good at and just be a blunt, straightforward person. Yeah. You know, us lesbians, we're not like straight girls. We don't dick around literally and figuratively, but we don't play those games. Yeah. That's why we're sexy. So we just say, hey, are you into me? Do you want to touch my vagina? Great. Move on. And she'll respect you for that, too.
There you go. Are you into me? Do you want to touch my vagina? Boom. Yay or nay. This is fucking easy. Don't be at the club. Hey. Oh. Let's kiss. Nah. You're playing games, sweets. You're playing motherfucking games. And I don't like that shit. I ain't buying it. I ain't buying what you're selling. So next time I motherfucking see you, if you as a straight lady who be flirting with a gay lady and I see it, I'm gonna put a stop to it. I'm gonna say, look, you better kiss her or get out of here. Okay? Don't be wasting her time, because us poor little lesbians, we get the googly eyes. And if y'all straight girls are like, woo, woo, come here, and batting your eyes and being all touchy-watchy and almost trying to kiss, but not really. Nah, fam. Nah, you're playing games, and we got to get out of that. So my advice to all y'all straight girls who be trying to be flirty with me at the club, you know I'm gay, and you be trying to be flirty with me at the club, do yourselves a favor. Stop! Don't do it. You either gonna kiss me or keep it moving. Oh, man. All right. And finally, some sound clips of the week. Oh, I just want to say one thing before I jump into the sound clips. How about that shitty ass Super Bowl? That's right. I didn't make my picks last week because you didn't catch that. If you didn't catch that, I did not make my picks about the Super Bowl because I thought it was a steaming pile of shit then, and it still is now. But I did bet on the Patriots to win in the coin toss. Thank you very much. Your host, Rambover, a.k.a. Miss Cleo. Tails, motherfucker. The coin says tails. God, and suck it, you Rams, you fake Rams fans. You jinxed yourselves. I knew y'all wouldn't win because of that call. It was supposed to be the Patriots Saints, and that would have been a way better game. But no, you Rams and your fair weather fans had to ruin it, and then y'all sucked a bunch of donkey dicks. You only scored like 3 points. Jog off. Go, Pack, go. This reformed gang member who is now spreading the word of Jesus Christ around town is going on and doing these seminars, and he's like, Jesus Christo, Christo, Jesus, I love you, Jesus, is the best thing ever. Check it out.
Put on salvation as your helmet and take the sword of the Spirit, which is the word of God, Jesus Christ. So put on the army of God. So we do it for God, Jesus Christ, belt of truth, Jesus Christ, so we do it for, we love you God, chestplate, Jesus Christ, of righteousness, we love you God, shoes, of peace, stomping on the enemy,
for the love of Jesus Christ. You got to go to my Instagram page at Gen T523 and watch this dude do the robot. Jesus Christ, we love you. Oh my God, I love it. I can't get enough of it. Anytime you sing along with rap songs, and a lot of times we think we're super skilled singing along with our rap song, especially if it's like Busta Rhymes or Eminem when they're rapping fast, or Twista or Mystical, but this is what you sound like. You sound ridiculous.
Oh my God. This motherfucker is trying to rap to Eminem is hilarious. And finally, crazy ass Live PD. Live PD never fails. I love Live PD so much. You see the hood of hood, the ghetto of ghettoist, the crackhead of all crackheads on Live PD. It is the greatest thing ever. I highly recommend. I'm a third of the way into season two. Almost on to a third of the way into season two, and then season three, and then I will be on the new stage of the newer shows of Live PD. But I'm just loving going back and watching them arrest people for weed, even though it's like legal now. It trips me out. So, but anywho, here's this crazy ass neighbor yelling to the cops.
What's your name, man? You know who I am?
I've never met you before.
I own this house.
Okay.
You own this house? Pick it up before 80.
Okay. Is that an idea or something?
No, I don't need no fucking computer. You're not even supposed to be here.
Says who?
What are you here for? I'm trying to eat dinner.
Because we have
got a warrant?
Because we have to
shut the door up here. No, because it's black at the door to call the cop. Now, do me a favor, because you don't belong here, and get away from me.
Who's this guy?
This guy is my tenant, Alan.
Alan, you come out here and talk to me for a minute, man?
Yeah. Give me
a f***. Anybody else live here?
That's it. You want to check that out? You want to see what the f***ing in the back, homeboy?
Sure, man.
Come check it out, man. You want to show me
this guy, you ain't supposed to be here. This guy's telling the cops that they're not supposed to be here. This crazy looking Andrew Dice Clay dude, you ain't supposed to be here. Do you know who I am? You ain't supposed to be here. And it turned out that this fucking beastly ass crackhead dude has a boyfriend, and his poor little boyfriend, he's like a 100-pound twink. Poor guy, they live in this mold infested a trailer that is just completely smashed to bits, and poor little Alan is like, I'm here for my safety. Who the fuck is this guy? Oh god damn it, watch Live PD, it's amazing. Watch Live motherfucking PD. And on that note, it is time for me to shut this thing off. It is certainly business hours in London. And I've got to go to the gym. Nope, I'm not going to bed. I'm going to the gym. Because I'm a crazy person. Oh, man. I got to get to 240, fam. I'm at 252. I got to get to 240. That's the next stop on this train. But before I go, please like, share, and subscribe to Ramble Bar Radio. RambleBarRadio.com. Tell all your friends, but only if they're cool friends. No negative Nancys. No sensitive Sallys. It's for the cool kids only, all right? But until next time, this is Rambo Radio and next year.